Are you ready for an epic adventure in enclosure design? In this video, I'll use SolidWorks to create an enclosure around an existing electronics project I created in Altium Designer. The project is a general purpose control panel with an LCD display, buttons, a USB connection, and a micro SD card socket that all require custom cutouts in the enclosure. We'll also look at how I 3D printed the enclosure to demonstrate how well the SolidWorks design fits the electronics design in the real world. Spoiler alert, it's a partnership in precision. Now, let's meet the star of the show, Altium's MCAD CoDesigner. This excellent tool makes it super easy to design and update your product's electronic and mechanical aspects without constantly sending files back and forth between different teams. With MCAD CoDesigner, you can directly communicate design changes between Altium Designer and your mechanical design software like SolidWorks. So say goodbye to the ECAD-MCAD Divide and hello to seamless design integration. While I use SolidWorks in this video, the process is similar when using other mechanical design software. I'll cover some of these MCAD packages in future content. So consider subscribing and turning on notifications so you won't miss out on these videos. Hi there, I'm Mark Harris, one of Altium's team of industry expert consultants. I'm going to show you how to use SolidWorks and Altium Designer together using Altium's MCAD CoDesigner. You will see just how easy it is to bridge the gap between your electronic and mechanical designs. But first, let's take a quick peek at the control panel design I'll be building the enclosure around. I recently designed this simple board to use in several future hardware projects that take user input and display information. In 3D, it's an odd shape and requires quite a few openings in the enclosure. Since the button caps and the LCD have different heights, 3D printing provides the lowest cost enclosure option for this project. Let's talk about why bridging the ECAD-MCAD divide is so important. In the past, transferring designs between the electronic and mechanical design software often required exporting files in an intermediate format and then importing them into the other software. This process was time-consuming, really prone to errors, and challenging to coordinate and manage. That's where Altium's MCAD CoDesigner comes in to save the day. With this powerful tool, you can easily directly communicate design changes between Altium Designer and your mechanical design software like SolidWorks. This means that you don't have to worry about constantly sending updates back and forth between teams and trying to keep everything in sync. Are you ready to dive into SolidWorks and get started on the enclosure? First, I need to open the Altium MCAD CoDesigner panel in SolidWorks. You may need to enable the plugin after installing it for the panel to be visible. Next, I'll need to pull the board from Altium Designer into SolidWorks. To do this, click the pull button in Altium MCAD CoDesigner panel, choose the project, then choose a location for SolidWorks to create the assembly. This will create an MCAD board assembly based on the board in your Altium 365 workspace. As the first step in designing the enclosure around the control panel, I'm adding an empty component to the assembly and aligning its planes with the board. Then, while still in the assembly, I can edit the enclosure component in place, sketching out the outline of each and every feature that needs an opening in the top surface of the enclosure. But wait, the fun doesn't stop there. I also add reference geometry to the side view, giving me crucial information on the component elevations and clearance requirements. With this information in hand, I switch over to the enclosure document and get to work on building the actual enclosure. As I create the enclosure, I must also consider the materials I'll be using and any pesky manufacturing constraints that might get in my way. For example, even though my 3D printer is a work of engineering genius and very precise, the components on the circuit board may only sometimes align perfectly with their pads. This is especially true for those pesky through-hole parts, like buttons on the control panel. These types of components have some wiggle room around the leads, which can cause them not to perfectly align. Depending on the manufacturer and manufacturing process, this may also apply to the board outline tolerance. I'm leaving half a millimeter of clearance between the 3D printed enclosure and any PCB features. I also have to account for the added dimensions of the button caps, as they were not in my board design. Unfortunately, I ran into some supply chain issues and couldn't source all the button caps I wanted. So instead, I'll be 3D printing a few custom button caps for this project. I bet you can't wait to see how they turn out. I'm building in standoffs to mount the board directly into the enclosure by extruding the standoff down to the board. The board already has mounting holes, so this should be a breeze. While screwing directly into 3D printed plastic is viable, it's not a very robust solution if you attach and remove the board several times. That's why I'm going to use threaded brass inserts. Sure, my inserts are cheap, but they have metal threads that can handle a board's repeated attachment like a champ. The enclosure also needs cutouts on the side for USB connector and the micro SD card. Since the wall thickness on this enclosure is relatively thick, I will be a little creative and make the cutouts more complex and stylish. Not only will this provide clearance for the USB connector, but it will also make it possible to grab that little SD card. And that's it. In record time, I have used SolidWorks and Altium MCAD CoDesigner to design an enclosure around an existing electronics project. With MCAD CoDesigner, it's easy to bridge the gap between your electronic and mechanical designs, saving you time and eliminating the need to constantly send updates back and forth between teams. Now, I'm sure you're dying to know how this looks in the real world. I'm using a 3D printer with dual extruders, which means I can use a soluble support material to hold up the overhangs and intricate parts of the enclosure during the print. This makes it super easy to remove the support material once it's finished, leaving a professional looking print. The translucent blue makes me think of early game consoles with transparent enclosures. Once the support material has been dissolved away, it's time to test the fit. And there you have it, a perfect fit. And thanks to Altium's MCAD CoDesigner, the whole process was a breeze. This tool lets you quickly and seamlessly integrate your electronic and mechanical designs, saving you time and hassle. Now that you've seen how easy it is to use Altium's MCAD CoDesigner to seamlessly integrate your electronics and mechanical designs, it's time for you to try it out. Altium's MCAD CoDesigner is genuinely a game changer in bridging the ECAD-MCAD divide. If you're already an Altium user, open up your Altium Designer software and give MCAD CoDesigner a spin. If you still need to become an Altium user, now is the perfect time to sign up for a free Altium trial and experience the magic of MCAD CoDesigner. This is just one example of how Altium's MCAD CoDesigner can seamlessly integrate your ECAD and MCAD designs. The best part about CoDesigner is its bi-directional capabilities. So you can transfer changes to the board geometry and component placement between Altium Designer and your MCAD design software. The receiving engineer can then accept or reject any changes, ensuring that your design stays accurate and up to date. I'll be covering this aspect of my next MCAD CoDesigner video, where I'll start the design with an enclosure shape in SolidWorks and move back and forth between the electronics and mechanical design to bring a new product to life. Don't be shy. Let me know in the comments what you think of this video and if you have any questions about Altium's MCAD CoDesigner. I'll do my best to answer them for you. Thanks for joining me on this journey, and I hope you learned something new about bridging the ECAD-MCAD divide. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to click the like button and subscribe for more exciting electronics projects. And remember to leave me a comment below and let us know what you think of CoDesigner. I can't wait to hear your feedback.